Okay, continuing on with the anatomy of the bug out bag. The last thing we talked about, I believe, was the items in this pouch. And we had a composition book and a poncho and some extra socks, which I do a lot down here. We're going to start out with the floor section and find out all the pieces and parts down in here. Okay, the first thing that you saw me do is unhook that, and that's probably just a regular bungee strap. The bungees are nice to have. You see I've got some of these bungees here. These are nice in a to tie down your tarp and you get to set up camp, because you don't want to rigid tie anything. If you catch up on a high wind and you've got your tarp tied down rigidly, you will break something. You gotta have, something's gotta give. Something's got to give. So the bungees are nice, and they bind things together. You can use them to bundle wood when you're, you know, you're out trying to get some wood for fire. How about tourniquet if you needed to? You can tourniquet anything with those. Not bad to have some of those. Okay. Alright, so what we got here is this finder. I picked this up at a thrift store, and it's designed to put pop or beer cans in. I think it holds like four of them, but I'm using it for a different purpose. And this up, and what I've got in here is a takedown bolt that I made. And I get more parts in there, but let's go ahead and put the bow together. I've marked the pieces with one line. And here on with this and handle, so that's pretty easy to put together. So we get a better shot. Let's see. Okay, so there's the bow. And what we've got here is the string. And put the string here on one side. I hope this is picking this up okay. And I'll do another video on this later outside. Alright, so put the string on the knot, or the whatever the notches that are in the wings. And then pretty much step through like you would in a regular bow. Bend this. Pull that up. And there is the takedown bow. I have in here the arrows, or the other arrows, that still have good knots on. All right, so there's the bow. And for what it is, this is a very quick light option for something that doesn't cost but a couple dollars put in my kit. And it's about a 35, 37 pound bow. I tested it, and that's what it tested at. I also have more arrows. I've got 3 arrows in here. So I could what else we got in here? I threw this in here. And what we have here is some hooks. We've got some eyelets. This is some more fishing stuff. We've got some in the other, one of the other videos, I show how you make a hook or a barb for bow fishing, and that barb is in here, and I've got extra safety pins for that purpose. Okay, and strip pins in just about every little container. Bow fishing items. Yeah, remember me telling you about lashing a line from here to here, and that's in a straight rigid line. Use some of the green line, and here's your barb. So you've got your whole kit here for hunting small game. You could take a deer with this thing at if you can get within a few yards of a deer. You can take down a deer, smaller animals. There's your barb for your bow fishing. Let's see what else we got in here. I do plan on putting some broadheads in here at some point. Probably the ones that fold down and will expand upon impact. But I've got more barbs, a lot more safety pins, I've got more heads, fuel points, and I've got some of that removed. Set the camera so you may not have seen any of that. If I didn't, I will redo this one. Okay. So again, I got a small fishing kit. I've got all the items in here that I need for bow fishing. And this, everything breaks down. It fits. Inside the container that I have for it. Again, here's the bow. so they were glued together when it came apart. They were supposed to. Sorry about that. So anyway, breaks right down. Survival bulbs. Alright. I will start another video and keep going on the survival stuff. On the anatomy of the break.
Hey, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe and rate the video, leave a comment, or even a video response. In the description down below, you'll find a link that will take you to the website, Logic Group LLC. From the website, you'll be able to go to the forum page and engage in conversation on different topics. You'll be able to link into the Facebook page, Logic Group's Facebook page. You'll find a tab that'll take you right back to the YouTube channel. You'll find email and contact us. So if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, you can leave them on any of those different platforms, and we'll engage in that particular topic and open it up for discussion and dissect it. Right here is a QR code, so if you got your phone handy, go ahead and snap that. That'll take you right to the website as well. The website is mobile friendly, so you can use it on your phone as well. Alright, so anyway, thanks a lot, and again, check back, and we'll have lots of videos to come with lots of good information and content in it. Don't forget to subscribe and rate the video down below. Those things really help. Alright, you guys, thanks, and have a great day.